Hey guys, Portia here, and today I'm going to be working on converting my Epson EcoTank 2760 to a sublimation printer. So I brought this about 2 summers ago. I have not used it very much. If you look at the tanks here, they are still pretty full. So what I'm gonna do is empty the tank of the regular ink, go ahead and clean it with some solution, and then go ahead and add in some sublimation ink. Have not done this before. Everything I know is based on watching YouTube videos, so we are going to see how this will work out for me. All right, so I have turned the printer on. I went to do a print, and then I unplugged it so that the cartridge would move from being in the right hand corner. And this way we can kind of move it back and forth a little bit. You don't really want to do this. This isn't something you do on a regular basis. But first thing I'm gonna do is go ahead and remove this little cover here. And I am wearing gloves because I know that this can become a little bit messy. Okay. And I am going to take out this tube here. This goes to the big black tank. And I did do a little test last night, which is why you see a little bit of black ink on here already, just to see how easy it was to come out. And it is super easy. Okay. And so what I am gonna do is go ahead and put a syringe in here. And I should be able to pull out the black ink. And I'm going to continue to do this until the cartridge of black is completed. Like I showed you guys earlier, my tanks are completely full because they did not get a lot of use out of them. And so I am going to go ahead and put the ink into a little plastic bottle that I have here. And with the black one, I know that this is going to take me a while. So I'm gonna go ahead and clean out all of the ink wells, let's call them. Okay, so the tanks are all clear, and I put the inks in these bottles here. The thing is, now I don't know what I'm gonna do with them, so I'm like, should I really have kept them? I have no idea. But I do know that the tanks are clear, which is the number one thing. So I did not see this online. Normally you clean your ink heads when it's a little clogged, but I thought since we were transitioning inks, it would be a good idea to just go ahead and clean that. So let's set up to do that. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and use this cleaning solution right here. What we are going to do is, try to get this in shot for you guys. Fill a syringe. All right. Sit this aside. And we're going to do the black first. We don't need that little nozzle anymore. We are going to take our syringe filled with the solution and put it right there on the head, nice and snug. And so I have a paper towel under the carriage already. That's going to catch the solution. And we're just gonna push that through. Okay, and I could imagine that this is a mess underneath here, you see? So I'm gonna go ahead and change out that paper towel. So I'm gonna go ahead and do all 4 cartridges, and when we come back, we should be able to, yeah, this is so messy, y'all. We should be able to go ahead and add in our sublimation inks. All right, guys, so I went on ahead and cleaned all of the printer heads. So that is done, and I am going to be using this sublimation ink here. It's specifically made for Echo Tanks, which I thought was pretty awesome, because if I didn't buy this one, all I would have had to do was push the ink in. Just like I pulled it out, I would use a syringe to push the ink in. But this just makes life easier. So if you have used an Echo Tank before, you know that all you have to do is put this right here. And, oops. I don't know if you can hear the cluck, 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 chuck, chuck, chuck sound. It's going to go ahead and fill the tank up by itself. So that just totally makes life much easier. So yeah, guys, I would say, based off of my experience here, I already had the Echo Tank. I had already upgraded my printer to a Canon PIXMA, and I really love it for my print thin cuts and different things like that. But since I already had this, I said, let's go ahead and we might as well convert it to a sublimation printer. And this was very easy. I was afraid to do it at first because I'm like, what if I break something? God knows, I guess we actually don't know if I did break anything, but that's what I was thinking at first. But it was a really easy process. These type of ink refills made it even easier. But yeah, guys, that is all I have for you today. If you got any questions, concerns, emotional outbursts, let me know. But until next time, peace.